I've had to constantly remind myself to set some boundaries and be forgiving of my own time so that I can still be up to speed and healthy and able to do my job and help take care of everyone else. My name is Teresa Wilson. I am the city manager in Columbia, South Carolina, and I'm a member of the Liberty Fellowship. I had to sum it up. What this year has looked like for me and our community is probably the word unpredictable. As the city manager of Columbia, my role consists of really overseeing the day-to-day operations. When the pandemic hit in March, we were in the midst of approving a budget for this current fiscal year that we're now in. And so we had to totally stop what we were doing, reflect, pivot, change, see how we could sustain the 2,300 employees' jobs. I have to ensure that service delivery is maintained for the over 133,000 citizens in Columbia. It's certainly been an undertaking that from the beginning brought some anxiety to just think about the scale of what we were dealing with and how we would ensure in the work that we do that the services continue. I mean, we wouldn't have, had a choice, but it then created additional worries and additional concerns about health and safety and protocols that we never would have imagined having to put in place. Dealing with the instability over this last year, I've had to show a lot of patience and give myself some grace. And also remind myself to balance priorities, even with, not just the work life, but my personal space and life. And I've had to constantly remind myself to set some boundaries and be forgiving of my own time so that I can still be up to speed and healthy and able to do my job and help take care of everyone else. But again, with all that encouragement and all that strength that you have to show, you have to also recognize how you may be internalizing the needs of others. Because I feel like I need to show this strong character and faith that I have to others to encourage them because I have, I've watched people suffer from COVID. We've tried to do everything we can, and I think we minimized it the best we could in our workplace and in our organization, with a municipality. A big part of your capital is the human capital. Unfortunately, we had to cut back a little bit so that we could also help our business community. And we set up loan funds for these organizations, nonprofit and businesses, just so they could sustain themselves and maybe keep their doors open. So the trade-offs were really about keeping people whole, keeping them going. What could we do as a city to ensure that they weathered the storm? But it really has just become, how do we sustain the basic service delivery? The lesson that I would take from this period of the pandemic is to not underestimate the ability of others and the ability of the community to come together, to be resilient, which I know is a word that's probably overly utilized, but it's really true that under some of the worst of circumstances, people will rise up and figure things out. I'm a leader who likes to put the right people around me. I think that's so important and that you build them up. That you don't necessarily hover, but you encourage them to stretch and grow. What I saw and continue to see through my team is a level of global thinking. If we had not placed emphasis on thinking globally, being able to be creative, being able to recognize a crisis moment and react to it in a way that's about finding solutions. I don't know how well we would have been able to pivot right now. My team, particularly with the budget, they just never missed a beat. And we've been able to really sustain ourselves in a way that I just honestly don't think any of us thought we would have been able to. And certainly, this has been a sad time frame for our country, not just with COVID, but with the racial injustice and different things that we've all had to experience and learn from each other. But at the same time, I think it's also created the opportunity for us as leaders to push ourselves a little bit further and see what all we're really made of.